welcome to Bonnie Book Reviews. Today I'm going to be reviewing the book series Friday Barnes. This book series was written by R.A. Spratt and it has 8 books in total. I only have 4 here because I have the rest of them on my Kindle, but I can't show them to you, so I just have these ones. This is a detective series, and that's because the main character, Friday Barnes, has to solve all kinds of different cases at her high school and outside of it as well. These books follow Friday Barnes, an 11-year-old girl detective at her posh boarding school, Highcrest Academy. And she's super intelligent and always correcting her teachers. She doesn't really understand social norms. She's never really paying attention in class, but only because she's read everything she needs to know about already, which means that often she turns to reading detective books, which is where she gets her inspiration from. She really enjoys solving cases, and luckily for her, Highcrest Academy is full of very rich students who often get themselves into trouble they can't get themselves out of, which means that she is constantly finding new and interesting things to distract her mind with while she's bored in class, and additionally, it means that she gets to skip PE, which is always an added bonus. I have 3 favourite characters in this series, and the first one is the main character, Friday Barnes. She is really intelligent and really fun to be around and is always highly entertaining. This is mainly because she doesn't understand the social norms of society. She's quite a unique character in the way that she dresses especially. She often tries to blend in with a brown cardigan, which actually makes her stand out more because people tend to notice it since it's rather ugly. She is often also wearing a pork pie hat that her uncle gave her because according to him, all detectives must have a hat. My second favourite character in this series is Melanie Pelly, Friday's best friend. She's just really entertaining, but only because she's constantly sleeping through lessons. And when she isn't, she wants to be sleeping, which means that really, she's no help whatsoever. But Friday keeps her around because they both kind of don't fit in, which means that they both understand each other. They also are often caught in different situations together because they're always hanging out. Another one of my favourite characters in this series is the headmaster. He's really sarcastic and funny and oftentimes can't be bothered to deal with Friday and her constant interruptions of his time. He always has a stash of chocolate biscuits nearby when he gets angry and loses his temper or when he gets tired. He also can't be bothered to deal with all the students that get sent into his office all the time for all of their silly pranks they pull on each other and the fact that their teachers just don't want to have to discipline them. The age group for this book series really does depend on the reader, but as a general guide, I would recommend it for 9 to 10 plus, just because some of it isn't violent, but it can be slightly on the scarier side, but it's not bad at all. So I think it really depends on the maturity of the reader, but I think readers 9 to 10 plus would definitely get the most out of this series. The thing I liked about this book series was that it was always fast-paced and intriguing, while also being highly entertaining along the way. It also shows the true value of friendship through the hardships that some of the characters face and how their friends are always there for you in the end. I really enjoyed reading this book and I think it was just a great book series, super fun, and just I really loved reading it. I'm giving this series 10 out of 10 stars because I absolutely loved it. There was nothing I disliked about this book series. It was really entertaining, really fun, and just something really nice to read. Don't forget, get geeky and start reading. I'll see you next time.